Welcome back. Today we're going to discuss another problem on bar chart connection design. Here is the problem statement. Two plates 10 mm and 18 mm thick are to be jointed by a double cover bar chart. Assuming cover plates of 8 mm thickness, design the joint to transmit a factor load of 500 kN. Assume Fe 410 plate and grade 4.6 bolts. So in this problem, we need to design the joint. That means we need to calculate number of bolts required to bear the load, that is factored load, and also the diameter of the bolt is not given here. I am assumed as 20 mm diameter of the bolt. By referring problem number 1 on butt joint in the last video, I have taken directly the shear strength of the bolt in double shear. Since it is double cover butt joint, the bolts will submit to double shear. That value is 103.31 kN. Here, if you observe, the main plate thickness are having different thickness, 10 mm and 18 mm. There is a difference between these two plates, that is 8 mm thickness gap between the main plate. If you see the figure here on the second page, if you see here, this is the one plate thickness 10 mm, another plate is 18 mm. The gap is 10 mm gap, 8 mm gap. So this gap we need to fill using a packing plate. So therefore, if you use a packing plate over the main plate, we should apply some correction according to the code section 10.3.3.3 of IS 800/2007. Here if you look into the code, here this is the section 10.3.3.3. The design shear capacity of bolts carrying shear through a packing plate in excess of 6 mm shall be decreased by a factor beta pk is given by beta pk equal to 1 minus 0.0125 TPK, where TPK is the thickness of the thicker plate in mm. In our case, the thickness of the packing plate is 8 mm. Since it is greater than 6 mm, we need to apply the correction. If it is less than 6 mm, no need to apply the correction. Therefore, if you apply the correction here, 8 mm thickness, if you substitute here in the formula, you are going to get 0.9. If you multiply 0.9 to the bolt where that is shear strength of the bolt, you are going to get 92.97 kN. Now we should calculate design bearing capacity of the bolt. So again, class 10.3.4. Here the KB value we should calculate, least of all these four. To calculate KB value, we want E and P. E I have taken as 1.5 here, P I have taken as 2.5. So 1.5 into diameter of the bolt to 30, they have taken 35 mm. P minimum 2.5 into diameter, I have taken 50 mm here. If you calculate KB, it comes out to be 0.507. So if you substitute the formula, VDB formula, 2.5 kb, that is 0.507 into d is 20 into thickness. Here main plate thickness we have 10 mm and 18 mm, and cover plate of thickness 8 mm. Here this is the value we should take as sum of cover plate thickness or main plate thickness, whichever is least. If you go for summation of cover plate thickness, that comes out to be 16 mm. 8 plus 8 16 mm. And in the main plate we have 18 mm on the one side and the other side is 10 mm. We should take as 10 mm as least plate thickness to calculate bearing strength. So this value comes out to be 83.14. If you what is the bolt, if you know the bolt value, what is bolt value is least value of shear and bearing strength. Shear strength of the bolt is here 92.97. Bearing strength of the bolt is 83.14. Therefore, this is the strength that covers the what capacity of the bolt. So now if you calculate number of bolts required, that will be equal to factor load by bolt value. Factor load is 500 newton given, and this comes out to be the value 6.0 numbers. Here we should provide nearest whole numbers. So in case of lap joint, in the last videos we had given nearest whole number. Here we should give nearest even whole even number. So we should provide what, 8 number here. This is the pattern I have provided, and how much bolts we need to provide. 8 number we should provide on one side. I have told in the last video also, in case of butt joint, we should provide numbers, or we should analyze whatever the thing, we should analyze only for one portion, half of the portion. Here I have provided what, 8 number of bolts in two rows. This is the row I have considered as this is row. I have provided 2 rows, 8 bolts. I will come back to this later. Now, we should calculate the width of the plate or the joint, how much we need to provide. For that, we want this pitch length. For that, so if you take in a per pitch length, two volts will come in per pitch length. Therefore, if calculate strength of a board per pitch length, since the two bolts fall in per pitch, that means if you take one pitch here, distance between two consecutive bolts, if you take section here, you're going to get two bolts in one section. Therefore, you need to multiply bolt value with two number, that will going to get 166.28 kilonewton. So this is the value of a strength of a joint. This one we need to equate to tensile strength of the plate to calculate the width of the plate or the pitch. So here, if you equate this value by using what tensile strength formula, that is TDN, that will be equal to 166.28.10. An here is P minus that is NDH or NDO into T into 410 by gamma MB. Here N is, I have taken as 1. Why N is 1? If you take section 1 here, that is tension failure either here or here or here or here. So in this section, upper pitch length only one bolt will come. Therefore, I have taken N equal to 1. This, if we substitute here, you will going to get P value 78.32. We should provide to take care about this load. But we have provided what already while calculating KB, we have provided 2.5 times of 20 diameter of the bolt, that is 50. Therefore, okay. So in along the one direction, we are going to provide 70 mm pitch. Along the other direction, we are going to provide 50 mm pitch. So N equal to 35 mm in both the direction, that is entry distance. If you look into the figure now, this is the detailing of the figure. Entry distance is 35. In along this direction, we have provided pitch as 75, 75, and 75. And along this direction, we have provided 50 mm pitch between the two bolts and entry distance. Gap is 5 mm between the plates, that is main plates. Again, entry distance 35 mm. Distance between the bolt pitch is 50. Again, entry distance 35 mm. So here we have provided what 8 number of bolts on one side of the joint, 8 number on the other side. So here, since we have provided backing plate, we need to provide two extra bolts. That is, you can use the same diameter of the board, that is M20 diameter. We have provided 2 diameter to get compact joint, the connection. So now we need to check the capacity of the joint for the given configuration. We have provided now the pitch in one direction, entry distance another direction, different pitch and packing plate, the diameter we have selected, everything. Now we need, and width also we fixed by fixing this, the arrangement. Therefore, now we need to check the capacity of the joint. The capacity has to be, you know, it is has to be greater than 500 kN. That means it has to transfer 500 kN external factored load. If it's failed to, you know, take care of that 500 kN, we need to redesign the joint. Otherwise, the design is okay. So now we look into that. You know, so we need to calculate the tensile strength of the plate according to class 6.3.1 of IS-800. So now TDN formula here is 0.10 AN FU by gamma MB. We know the formula. So here AN formula is B minus NDH into T. What is AN here? Number of bolts falling in a selected section. Here we are taking what? This section. In any section, if you take this section, this or this, number of bolts are falling in the section is, you know, 4 bolts. We need to deduct the 4 bolt hole diameter from 295. Therefore, B minus N is 4 DH, diameter of the bolt hole into thickness of the plate 10 mm into FU by gamma MB into 10 power 3 to get the answer in kilonewton. That comes out to be 611.06 kilonewton, which is greater than given factored load. Therefore, the section is, the joint is safe. And also, whatever the configuration we are given for the pitch and ridge distance, then that is okay. Thank you.